Welcome in us. This lesson today we are going to see how do we eliminate theta in the given equations. And please don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Now, to eliminate theta, we always use the first three Pythagoras identities. The cos squared plus sine squared equal to 1, then this one and this. Now, for example, if you want to eliminate theta in number 1, we always ask ourselves what functions we have. So we have sine and we have cos. Then you ask yourself, is there a trig identity? Is there any identity that is left in sine and cos? You say yes. Why? Because the sine is here and cos is here. So you always make cos the subject and also sine the subject, like this. So to make sine the subject here, I'll take this sine and divide by 2. So x, and I take this, it becomes minus a, then I divide by 2. Sine theta. Then from here, when I take this side, I have y plus b, then divide by 3 equaling to cos theta. From here, so we have sine, we have cos, so then you put this, that from cos squared theta plus sine squared theta equaling to 1. Then you punch in, no cos is here, which is y plus b over 3, and the whole thing is what? It's squared. Then plus sine is here, x minus a over 2, the whole squared, equaling to 1, and remember, you see there is no any theta. When I come to this, you saw I have sec and cosec. You saw there is no any idea which is having sec and cosec, but you see, you see that sec, we are hiding cos. In sec there is cos and in cosec there is sine. First of all, you make cosec the subject and sec the subject. From here, we have the y over b equaling to cosec theta. From here, you see that in sec there is cos and in cosec there is sine. So I get the reciprocal. So if I get the reciprocal of this, I'll be having a over x. Now the reciprocal of sec becomes cos theta, and from here, if I get the reciprocal of this, becomes b over y equaling to the reciprocal of cosec is sine theta, and from here, you see that cos theta and sine theta, they are having the identity that is combining them. So from here, I'll be having cos squared theta plus sine squared theta equaling to 1. Substituting them, you see cos is here, it will be now a over x, the whole squared n plus sine is here as b over y squared equaling to 1. And from there, it's that we have eliminated our theta. In number 3, you see we have now tan and cos. When you check in these three identities, you see that there is no n which is left in tan and cos. But you see that the one which is added in tan is 1 plus tan equaling to sec theta. And you see that if you get a reciprocal of cos, it will be giving you a sec. So from here, if I take this to something, I have x over a equaling to tan theta, comma. From here, I have y over b equaling to cos theta. From here, I start my tan is already here, but I'm missing a sec. So if I get a reciprocal of this, I'll be adding now b over y equaling to, when I get a reciprocal of this, now this one becomes sec theta. And now I put this identity that 1 plus tan squared theta equaling to sec squared theta. Now I substitute, so 1 plus my tan theta is x over a whole squared equaling to sec is there as b over y squared. And so there is no any theta. When it comes to this, is that we have sec and we have cos, and there is not an identity which is combining the two. First of all, you see that here the sec is a reciprocal of cos, or cos is a reciprocal of sec. So you make one the subject. So from here, if I get x over a equaling to sec theta, from here we have the y minus b over 2 equaling to cos theta. Now, let's express what the terms of the C'est ça, les filles qui ont reçu le premier poste, à l'insect, à l'arrière du poste. Donc, pour moi, my A over X will be, le reçu le premier poste will be cos theta. And so, we have cos theta and cos theta, meaning that this will be equal to this, and so this will be equal to this. Therefore, my A over X is equal to Y minus B over 2. Because cos theta is equal to cos theta. Now these ones, you see that you have sine cos and sine minus cos. So here the idea is you call this one equation 1 and you call this equation 2. Now we eliminate 1 by 1. So to eliminate cos, we shall add equation 1 plus equation 2. So 1 plus 2. Here we see that if I add this to this, I'll be having x plus y equaling 2. If I add this to this, I'll be having 2 sine theta. And if I add this and I add it to this, a cos and negative cos, it will cancel. So making sine the sum is there, I have x plus y over 2 equaling 2 sine theta. Now, still now to make cos the subject, you see I will subtract equation 1 minus equation 2. So from here 1 minus 2, I have now x minus y. Then if I say sine minus sine, it will go to 0. Then cos minus minus cos, it will give me 2 cos. 2 cos theta. Divided by 2, you have x minus y over 2 equaling to cos theta. And so that you have sine and cos, and the identity that relates those two is the first one here. So meaning that my cos square root theta plus sine square root theta equaling to 1. From here, I'll be adding my cos as x minus y over 2 the whole square root plus x plus y all over 2 square equaling to 1. And from there, members, you start with this cos theta. So please try out this. I wish you the best. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel.